So I can see psychologically that there is a two-way movement. One movement comes from the machine to the human, and one version goes from the human to the machine. So if we think about the first movement, first of all, this movement from the machine to the human, more and more modern people think of themselves as a machine. In English, we talk about people who are hardwired, which is a classic machine thinking, or you talk about people who are programmed. This is all an example of this kind of machine thinking, that really we are really computers. But one of the very important things is to understand the difference between a metaphor, a useful metaphor, or a picture, compared with an actual description or a definition. So when we think about the human brain, it is a useful metaphor to say that the brain is like a machine. There are many aspects of the brain which are machine-like. It's true. The same kind of processes that you see in a computer, you can see that similar processes are happening in our brains. But you cannot say that the brain is a machine. That's to confuse the metaphor with the description. So, in fact, to say that the brain is a machine is both false, it's just wrong, but actually it's incoherent. It doesn't make any sense. Because every machine you ever met was a machine designed by a human being for a human purpose. When you say the brain is a machine, it's not a machine because it wasn't designed by a human being and it doesn't have a human purpose.